Well, here we are in Windhelm. Whenever I turn around, my companions have a different hat on because of the cold, because Wet and Cold likes to throw hats on people and throw cloaks on, you know, all these people have a cloak or a hat on.
My friend, a toast to a
like this guy here, he hasn't gotten the word yet from Wet and Cold. Probably when I turn around and then look at him, he'll be all suited up. Yeah, wet and cold works when you're not looking at it. So while my back is turned, he's gonna go change outfits.
Look elsewhere. I'm afraid I have absolutely no idea what you're speaking of. Fine. Here, take this.
That's all she says? I think that was an added thing. See now.
Hello, friend.
Now he's got a hood on.
Got any ale or mead?
Next time I see him, he might have a frickin' cloak.
Yes, yes. Now, to find myself a drink.
I've been a bit out of sorts since...
Now, if they're already wearing a hat, they won't get a hood added.
I'm as resourceful as I am discreet.
And I found out why this guy's neck doesn't move. He doesn't look at me sometimes.
I understand you purchase used goods as well.
It's because he's in the middle of talking to somebody.
Yes, that's right. Whether or not I'm interested depends on what you've got, of course.
I have some things
his
that belong to my daughter.
His script has the lowest priority in the marketplace here.
Got any ale or mead?
So he's the last merchant to talk to anyone.
Oh, I see. You've been a good friend in a time.
But once he's done talking, and we won't forget that, to whoever wants to talk to him, then he'll look right at me when I click on him.
People laugh at things they don't believe.
Could be a bug. It could be that he gets told that someone's going to walk up to him and talk to him. Rumor is, but that person might be clear on the other side of Windhelm.
I have a lot of respect for Ambar's friend, Ar.
See, now he's looking at me.
His views are a little extreme.
So he'll stand there and he'll wait until that person eventually shows up sometime during the day to talk to him. Everyone else, when they're told someone's going to come talk to them, that person's usually standing near their booth. Uh-oh. Yeah, I had forgotten about this quest. I've been putting off coming here, doing this. Last time I was here was with Rigmor, doing her little quests.
I was one of the best soldiers in the Stormcloak army. Oh, thank you. Divines bless your fine heart.
Is that true?
Good day.
I want to believe him.
Hold it there. Keep your distance. Another girl killed. This is Susanna, from Candlehearth Hall. Served me a drink just a few nights ago.
I don't
ago,
think I met her in this playthrough.
I can't say I knew her.
I was lollygagging, and it was sort of late in the game when I eventually came to Windhelm, so
young
she was...
girl killed at night, body torn up.
When you reach a certain level in the game, I believe...
We're stretched thin as it is with a war.
Or when you reach nobody a certain date of the year... She gets murdered.
But it's the truth.
It's gonna happen whether you show up or not.
If you
want to
help,
time.
Ask some of these gawkers if they saw anything useful. I'm going to examine the body before the rats can
it's
get.
It's predetermined time or level setting. One of the two, maybe both. Before she gets killed.
This is a shame. No, sorry. But I did notice that her coin purse was still intact, so whoever did this wasn't after gold. I'm going to keep preparing the body, if you'll excuse me.
I want to say that after 3 weeks of game time, she's dead. Usually, after 3 weeks of game time, you've already reached, you know, level 7 or level 8. And if you haven't been to Windhelm by then, you know, she's already dead.
Another one. Terrible.
You won't be able to get to meet her.
Up to no good, are we?
She's one of the,
I'll teach you, but it'll cost you.
What do they call it? She's one of the trophy wives in the game.
I heard a scream and came running, but she was already like this when I got here.
Some would argue that there's three trophy wives in this game. One in Riften, one in Windhelm, one in Whiterun.
The divine smile on a charity.
And I'm trying to think, is there one in Markarth?
Always sad when someone has to die. Sorry, I thought I saw a fellow running away, but didn't get a good look at him.
I guess there's the daughter of the innkeeper over at Markarth.
If you've got some time,
she's kind of young, though.
Stop by my house of curiosities. I promise you'll see wonders.
What is he talking about? He sounds like P.T. Barnum. What was the other town that had... Oh, was there a trophy wife over at Solitude? I'm trying to think.
Yes?
I don't remember any at Solitude.
Tell me, what do you want? Yes?
Maybe,
Stonefist is so hateful towards elves and Argonians.
I guess I would say the Emperor's cousin. She's probably a trophy wife.
Shall we continue?
Staying safe, I hope. Just like always. Nobody saw anything useful. Bastards escaped again.
So I guess that's the five holds
Look,
right there.
Friend,
so yeah, each hold has
do
a trophy
than
wife.
The Legion of Guards, be my guest.
I need to talk to the steward, though.
If you count the girl over at
Markarth. Anyone go around claiming to be on official business. If he's willing, then we'll talk.
I don't know if that was on purpose with Bethesda or what, but they tended to, not glamorize too many of the females in the game. They didn't go with the whole supermodel look as a default for the characters. And if you remember your vanilla Skyrim, you'll remember that almost all the women are ugly in the game. It's not until you start doing female replacer mods that you notice, hey, there's actually some nice looking women in this game.
Maybe I'm the Dragonborn. These are difficult times indeed, when men stalk their brethren like beasts. My men are stretched thin as it is.
If I want to say that Bethesda gave up with trying to make realistic looking female faces with the limited number of triangles they had for polygons. So they probably wanted to hide that fact by making their skin textures the most ugliest they could come up with. They did that with Fallout 3, they did that with Oblivion.
Whoever we replaced them with.
They did that with Morrowind. They cover up ugly with more ugly to hide the ugly. Know what I mean? Like if you don't have the polygons to make an attractive face, just hide the face. Don't even show the face. Or paint over the ugly face with an even uglier face.
Need something?
To hide the fact that the polygons.
Until next time.
Needed to make a nice looking face don't exist. They did that with Lara Croft back in the day. Her face was so ugly you didn't get to see it ever in the game. You stared at her ass the whole time you're playing the game. That was for a reason. Her face looked like the Jack in the Box guy. Just a round circle with a cone for a nose.
We are their families.
Well put, friend. Tell me, Gottmar, why do you fight for me?
I'd follow. But then the modders come along. You know, I'm using the mature skin texture.
Yes, but why do you fight?
And it's a world of difference.
What then?
What it does with the faces.
I'll die before elves dictate the fates of men. Are we not one in this?
Then you find out that you're
fight for the men I've held in my arms.
I guess the lowest common denominator is the polygons for the face that are used. Because you're thinking, oh, why can't she be prettier? And then you look at the polygons used on her face and you're like, oh, okay.
Strangers wearing familiar faces. I fight for my people. Impoverished to pay the debts.
And when you're making a character, you got the presets. You only have presets to work with, have you noticed? Someone's gone through all the trouble of doing all the noses, all the eyeballs, eyebrows, earlobes, chins, cheeks, mouths, corners of mouths, the heights of the mouth, the height of the lips, the thickness of the lips, the height of the nose, how wide the nose is, how skinny a nose is, pointy, not pointy, slanted forehead, bulging forehead, chin sticking out, no chin. Someone did all those presets for you. And there's certain combinations that you do, and all of a sudden, your guy looks ruggedly handsome, or your girl looks totally hot. But it's very rare with the number of polygons the game gives you to use. So other modders have come along and they've replaced the face with the whole other face. Is probably true. With a high definition face. But then you have to use their character generator to alter the face, because they're using totally different polygons.
Whatever I don't already know. Power is the crux of this world. There's always more.
So when you're on YouTube, you see a Skyrim video,
in the right places.
And you're wondering why the women in the game look so hot. Well and good, but it's because the guy, or the girl, just broke the heads off all the Barbie dolls and stuck new ones on. Completely new Barbie doll heads. From scratch. Because you're probably at home on your game trying to figure out how to get your characters to look as good as the ones you saw in a video. It's not going to happen.
All right then.
But it's weird how on the forums people will say, oh, does this mod use vanilla hair?
I'm so glad.
That's a major concern, vanilla hair. But hardly anyone ever says, does this mod use vanilla faces? You don't see that posted too much in the forums. No one seems concerned if a mod uses vanilla faces or not. Because usually everyone's already replaced the faces in their game. That's when you see people post in the forums about neck seams. My character has a neck seam. The neck seam is when it can mean two things. There's a gap between the neck and the chest on the body. You see a crack. You can see inside the body because there's a gap. The neck doesn't touch the body at all. That's one definition of neck seam. Another definition would be the head's connected to the body, but right where it connects, you see this crease, this fold. It's like a fold in the skin. Looks unnatural. That's when the normals on both the body and on the face, they don't match. You know, the neck, texture, normal maps and stuff don't match the neck with the body. There's a way to fix that with certain 3D programs that are made for Skyrim. You push a button and it fixes that and it makes the face tint match the body tint. Otherwise you end up with a nice tan body with a gray colored face. That's no good. Yeah, I noticed that this house already has a marking on it. I'll have to look in the Shadow Marks book to see what that means. Maybe it means nothing's in this house. It's empty. Don't bother robbing the place. Anyway, so I came here to talk to the mother of the girl that was murdered. Not the one outside, but the girl before the one outside. She was murdered. And the mom still has the key to the daughter's house, which is, I want to say it's next door.
I've been a bit out of sorts since our daughter was taken from us. I'm sorry. She was very dear to me.
It's weird how I was able to just walk right into the house.
I'd rather not talk about my daughter, if you'll excuse me. Well, all right. What exactly do you need to know?
Usually I'll talk to her outside when she's at the market.
Yerim?
But for whatever reason,
I'm not sure what you think you'll find there, but you're welcome to have a look.
So anyway, back to my fried rice experiments. For a week now, I've had this rice cooker. I've been trying to make other kind of foods with it. I'm not much of a rice person. And I found out that these rice cookers, you pretend that you're cooking rice, but you're really... I like to cook pasta. I like doing macaroni. You know, noodles, that kind of thing. So today I learned that I shouldn't put as much water as it calls for to do rice. Noodles use less water than rice does. And I shouldn't wait for the machine to turn off on its own. I should set a timer and use that to determine when to turn off the rice cooker. Because in the book it says, oh, it's going to take like half an hour to cook rice or whatever. Well, maybe. But if I'm cooking pasta in the steamer, it only takes 20 minutes. It shouldn't take more than 20 minutes to boil noodles. Because what the machine does is, after 30 minutes, it then spends 10 minutes doing cooking. I don't want the noodles cooked. They're already cooked. I don't want the thing to be on a cook for 10 more minutes when there's no more water left because it all steamed away. So I've learned now that I should just turn the machine off before it gets to that last 10 minutes where it starts doing the countdown. Because by then, the noodles are soft and mushy. So I got a timer yesterday. The kind that you wind up, and it's been working great. I set it for 20 minutes, and when it goes off, I shut off the rice cooker, and I open the lid, and the noodles inside are perfect. And then I just pour whatever kind of sauce I want, and cheese, and whatever I want on top of it. Close the lid for about 2 minutes. Gives the cheese a chance to melt and a chance for the sauce to heat up. Because that pot is scorching hot.
The dark elves are uneasy. There's a
killer on
the streets.
I can't believe Isabella's gone.
It takes a while for it to cool down.
She was such a helpful young lass.
How would you like a drink?
May you lose yourself in the pages of a good book.
Coming right up.
Yeah, because for a couple days I'd open up the thing, I'd open up the rice cooker, expecting perfect pasta inside like I see on the YouTube videos. And the noodles would be mushy and then cooked to the bottom of the pan. So it's like, that is the complete opposite of what I wanted.
Until next time.
So I've been watching the YouTube videos again. And they're giving out wrong information. They're editing their video. Obviously, they messed up too, and they had to redo something. They don't mention that in their video. I was thinking maybe I should do a rice cooker video on how to make pasta. At least for the rice cooker I own.
Yes?
Sure.
It comes down to things like, yes. What kind of water do you use? You know, hard water, soft water. Are you at sea level? That kind of thing. What's the barometric pressure? Are you at one atmosphere, two atmosphere? Is the water salty? You know, that kind of thing. And, you know, did you rinse all the starch out of your noodles first? And what else? Yeah, all these little scientific equations you have to take into account. Oh, and the brand of the noodles?
I own Hollyfrost Farm outside the city. It's honest work, if a bit dull.
I notice every brand of noodle has totally different instructions on how to boil their noodles. Have you noticed? It's really weird. There's no scientific answer.
Got some fresh baked bread and good cheese if you're after a bite to eat. Sure thing. It's yours for a day. I'll show you to your room. Right this way.
And then I think the instructions that came with my rice cooker might be translated from Chinese.
You know about Talos?
To Americanese.
He founded the Empire.
And maybe not very well.
Blessings of Talos be upon you.
So who knows if I'm following the right instructions. So anyway, my plan was to do the Blood on the Ice quest up to the point where I get the key to the house. And I tell the steward that I'm helping the guards outside investigate the murder.
Watch what you're doing.
So that's all I'm going to do at this point, is just that much. Just to get the naked dead lady out of the yard. Every time I come to Windhelm, she's laying there.
Yes?
So now her body's been taken to the Hall of the Dead to be embalmed. But I don't really need to talk to her. I can just go follow the trail of blood to the house, which I did, I think. And then, in this playthrough, I'll talk to,
all right,
the wizard, the court mage guy, at the right time, so that another girl doesn't die in the game. He'll help me catch the criminal. So he doesn't have to be thrown into jail first. I'm going to skip all that. Usually the other girl that gets killed is someone you don't want to die in the game.
That Aventus Aretino is doing the Black Sacrament, trying to summon
these two have been standing out in front of
the
Aretino house for, I want to say, 5 game years.
Fine, then I'll invite him out to play. He lives right there. I'm going to knock on his door.
They've been waiting for me to walk by so that their scene can play out.
That house, they are cursed.
Ha! Then I'm right. I knew it. He's trying to have somebody killed.
All right. I won't deny.
So kids wear cloaks now. That's kind of cool.
Aventus Aretino walks a dark path.
Before, they would only wear hats, you know, when it's cold outside. They never wore cloaks. So that's the, what do you call that? The Kids Are All Right mod. It allows kids to wear.
Is someone there?
It allows kids to work better with wet and cold. I'm not using. I don't think I'm using armor and clothing for kids. I don't think I am. I'll have to double check on that. Because I think the kids are alright. I think they'll wear any clothes you give them.
My sister and I once traveled the world to assemble our collection. Such adventures we had. A most pleasant chat. Until the next.
What was that about? I wasn't paying attention. How did I get in this place? Did I walk in or did I knock? Okay, I see what I did. I knocked on the door and he used Fandol's voice to answer the door because there's no voice for the merchant to answer the door with. That was kind of messed up. Is someone there? Yes, Fandol, let me in.
Is someone there?
Okay, his voice matches the NPC he's role-playing.
All my goods are legitimate, which is more than I can say for some. Of course nothing in here is stolen. Only a careless, shameful, idiotic fetcher would do something as stupid as to buy pilfered.
Did he know who I was when I came in here?
Azura, I've made a terrible mistake.
Wow, it said unknown when I ring, and Viola Giordano has been waved my mouse over just here. Like it. So I've never met this guy, and he let me into his store when it was closed.
You have to get it to her some other way.
So he wants me to do this quest where I'm supposed to put back Viola's ring.
The ring into her house. Put it in a dresser or something. I will make it worth your while. Don't let Viola catch you in her house.
Normally, without the knock-knock mod, or simply knock or whatever it's called, you would have to pick the lock, sneak in here, and then he would say, "What's the meaning of this? Can't a man have a little privacy?" Or, "I'm gonna call the guards if you don't leave," that kind of thing. But because I knocked, and because I have a reputation in Windhelm, which is a good reputation, I'm Dragonborn, I'm saving the world, all that kind of stuff, he's like, "Certainly," and he lets me in. He doesn't trust me, though. He's, like, spying on me, making sure I don't eat his food.